Remember we placed that order for Bajaj Auto in this module? Well, we'll continue that journey of what happened actually after we purchased those shares of Bajaj Auto. What we placed was a CNC order or a cash and carry order for delivery. Now, I'm going to be using Zerodha Kite for this, but the nomenclatures may vary for other brokers, but the process is the same. Hi, I'm Prateek Singh, and in this video, we'll understand what happens after you purchase a stock and something called the settlement cycle. Remember when we placed the order for Bajaj Auto to buy? When that happened, before the orders actually went to the exchange, the broker actually checked whether I have enough funds in the account. That was validated. If I have enough margin or enough money, then the order was fired to the exchange, a match was made, and the transaction was done. On the day of the transaction, that day is represented with the letter T and is called T day, which means transaction day. So the transaction day or the T day is very important because all settlement happens with respect to it. So when we purchase Bajaj Auto, let's say on Monday, that's your T day, then happens T plus one, which is the second day, which is Tuesday. On this day, the quantity sits on T1, you will see on Kite. Let me show this to you. On Kite, we will see in the holdings tab that Bajaj Auto has T1 quantity. One day after that, that's T plus two, which is Wednesday now. So we purchased Bajaj Auto on Monday. T plus one, that's Tuesday, is where we'll see T1 quantity in the holdings tab on Kite. And T2, which is Wednesday, after the markets close on Wednesday evening, the shares will be credited to my DMAT account. Now I'll be able to see this on my Kite holdings tab as well as console. Let me quickly show you that. So here in Kite, T plus two evening, we can see that Bajaj Auto has been credited to my DMAT account. And I'll go to console, I'll go to this tab, and we can see that Bajaj Auto appears here as well. This is known as the settlement cycle or the T plus two cycle. Fun fact, in the Harshad Mehta days, the T plus two cycle didn't exist. In fact, the entire settlement cycle was 1 month long. So we've come a really long way. Now everything happens in just 3 days from transaction. It's important for you to understand the flow of money when we place that Bajaj Auto example. So when the order was placed on Monday, almost immediately the funds are blocked from my account and the funds are debited in the evening on Monday. After that, T plus one and T plus two happens. On T plus two evening is where we are credited with the shares. Maybe now what we can do is actually sell the shares and understand how that settlement works. So we have already seen the settlement from Monday through Wednesday. Let's see what happens if we want to sell Bajaj Auto on Thursday. And in this case, that will become the T day, representing with a red sell T over here. On this day, as soon as you do the sell transaction, which I'll do right now, so I'm placing the sell order. Now the sell order has been done. So I've made the sell transaction. Now what happens immediately is that 80% of the worth of the sell is credited to my account. We can use this money to buy other shares if we like, but we can't withdraw this money in cash yet because the settlement hasn't happened. Another thing that happens immediately is that the shares are debited from my account immediately. Then we have T plus one. In this case, this is Friday. Not much happens on this day as settlement is still happening, but settlement has not happened yet. On T plus two, since Saturday, Sunday is a holiday, our T plus two is going to be Monday. And on T plus two, which in this case is Monday, we can withdraw the balance 20%, which will be credited to our account Monday. We can withdraw the entire amount now because the settlement is now complete. Key takeaways from this video are,